Ladies and gentlemen, Investor Talk is back with a mining flash today. I welcome Lawrence Rolston. Recently, we met in Munich and discussed there. Lawrence, good to see you. You had some results to announce.
Yes, yeah, and we had very good results. You know, the grade in that hole was in line with other deposits in British Columbia. And in fact, they're operating mines with grades that are similar to what we generated from that first hole. You know, some people look at the copper separately from the gold and you know, each on its own doesn't look that high, but you put the gold and the copper together and it makes for an economic grade. So at the other point that's really important here is that we're not yet in the heart of the system. And in the cross section, in the news release, there's a cross section that shows the hole and the chargeability. And you can see that the hole is outside of the most intense part of the chargeability. So late in the season, after that hole was drilled, we did more geophysics, the IP or induced polarization. And that's what gave us that cross section. So we can see very clearly now that we're not in the heart of the system. We're close to it. We're getting good results, but there's potential for the results to be even better as we get into the heart of the system.
Lawrence, if you don't mind, let's have a look at the press release to see some numbers. Here is the press release from the 12th of December. And if we scroll downwards, that's DOC 2023-01, that is this hole. And if I see it correctly, it was fully mineralized, and this is a real long hole.
It was mineralized for 435 meters. And within that, there's 107 meters that is clearly within economic range for this type of deposit in this setting. So they're very good numbers, and especially for the first hole. And then if you scroll down a little bit to that cross section, and you can see the intense chargeability high that zone right there. And we're just clipping the edge of it. And you can see the mineralization in that hole, that highest part of the mineralization does align with where we're close to the chargeability high. So there's a lot of potential for better grades. It's wide open to depth. And we know in this type of deposit that these intercepts can go very deep. So very good numbers for the first hole. And we know where to go to get better grades. And it's completely open to depth. So we're very excited by this.
And there are still assays for three more holes open, right? Do you expect them to come in December or January?
We'll be announcing it early in December, early in the new year. We might get some of the assays late in the year, but given the holidays, that the announcement will be made early in the year. And it takes time from when we get the raw assays to put it together and look at the intervals and do the quality checks that we need to do before we announce the drill results. So very early in the new year, we will have further assays. And look, all of these holes intercepted long intervals of porphyry style, sulfide mineralization. So we're really looking forward to seeing the numbers on this. And I think investors are going to be very pleased when they see those numbers.
So good results, and only the market has to realize it. And there was another press release I found pretty interesting, Lawrence, that you got $1 million from Rossbeatty. And everybody in this industry knows Rossbeatty, of course. And he bought a property from you for $1 million. What's behind this? This is, by the way, roughly 10% of your current market cap that you got in as additional cash.
Yes, and I'm sure to a lot of people it looks strange. Look, Ross is working very closely with the First Nations and others to establish protected areas in the province. And this spirit of cooperation between us and Ross and the mining industry and the First Nations is very, very valuable for all parties concerned. It's helping to establish clear boundaries between areas that are protected and other areas that are open to development. So we'll have a lot more news on this. Ross is working with others to establish a significant area that is going to be designated a protected area. And by doing this, we are building relations with the First Nations, and we're establishing that clear boundary that's going to make it a lot easier for development on properties that are outside of the protected areas.
Sounds good, Lawrence. We are looking forward to more results. And now, because it's a mining flash, it has to be short and spicy. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a good New Year, of course, and a big hit. Thank you for the update today.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you. Bye-bye.